Good evening to all. This is Asutosh from NIT Agartala, and he is my teammate, Mr. Dev. So basically, our project was like improving SBHS remote ticket virtual life server and website. So as discussed by Anamika, we have been working for that framework that is already available in Python and Django. So there was several bugs in that framework. So basic work that we have done is like we have fixed some of the bugs. So we'll start with overview to our project. We'll see the introduction to our project. We'll see we have used Python for this is a setup. This part is entirely in IIT Bombay actually, and one can access it from outside the IIT Bombay. These are the SBHS that are connected to this Python Django framework. Connected to this, and this is the internet, and these are the users, client. They can access these SBHS and can perform their experiments. Next. This is the actual GUI of that present site. This is the login page actually. This was the problem. The main problem was like we have some Scilab codes. So if we are updating the Scilab code to the admin's account, so we'll have to update that Scilab code to the online server. So that was not working properly. So the thing is that when this part is working properly, but the part that means to pull the updated code to the online server is not working properly. The main cause was for that there was no such proper internet to this part. So we have given that internet access to the server. So now it is working properly. We'll show the demo. Next problem was key error problem. In this problem, what is going on? Like user will get a message like unable to connect the SBHS server. The problem was due to .pyc files. And what these .pyc files are? .pyc files are like when we compile a Python code .py file, it will automatically generate a .pyc file. .pyc files are like binary files and that are compiled version of that actual file. So what is the procedure to book a slot? Actually, when a user book the slot, there is a scan machine .py script. So that part will executed and corresponding .pyc file will generated. So what will happen if next time after 55 minutes, if someone comes and try to connect the SBHS, these .pyc files are already there. Maybe that machine has not responded, but the .pyc files are there. Means they have stored their port, so we have removed all these .pyc files after 55 minutes.
What are the information?
These are if you have to make the server lightweight, you can use these .pyc files. These are quite useful. Means they are the compiled version of .py file.
.py file, what yeah. The information you have kept?
.py file.
Necessary every time the user logs in.
Yeah. .py files are like to scan the machines. The machines are set there. I have shown that figure. Those machines are scanned after each 55 minutes.
Next. Going to
change after 55. Then after we have implemented a new concept, automatic slot booking. Actually, there is a concept of sample user already. The concept is like we'll have to check the proper functionality of our server. So how can an admin check this by own? So there is already a concept of sample user. There are 40 sample users right now, and there is a concept of auto login. When this script will run, automatically all the sample users will login out, and then after. It's come to automated slot booking. We have automatically logged in. But the thing is that if we have to check our server, so we'll have to go and book slot. And then after we'll check whether particular machine is working or not working. This automated slot booking, what we'll do, it will, when we will run this automated slot booking, it will automatically book a slot for all the sample users if the slot is available at that time.
Okay, anything remaining?
Yes, sir, one topic. One topic is
there. One. Demo we will skip. We understood what you have done, looking into the strict timeline. Okay. So if you any work is remaining, you can explain
yes,
it one minute.
There is a one work is about health monitoring and generating the health statistic of the server.
Okay.
Actually, the health statistic, health monitoring, we can say that it is just checking of the equipment at a regular interval of time. So in our case, the main problem was that the machine was checked only once in an hour. And if the machine was not responded at that particular time, it just skipped. So for this process, we have just implemented that if each machine will be pinged 5 times at each stage. Means if a machine is returning its port, it will be pinged 5 times to return its port. And if the result is more than 2 times, then it will be just passed to the next stage. Same process is applied for the machine ID. So by this, sir, if it fails, it will show an error, cannot connect to the, means whatever error is there, if it doesn't return the port ID, or if it doesn't return the machine ID, it will just return the error. And for all this, it will write in a particular string file, and that file, we have generated a log of that, all the machines that are on the server, that whether they are online or not at that particular instance of time.
Okay, thank you. Next.